Hi guys, welcome back to another YouTube video. So in this video, I will be giving you an overview of Apollo. So Apollo is basically a sales intelligence platform which has a database of around 250 million leads from almost 60 million companies. So you can basically use it to find prospects in any niche you want. Maybe it's in software business, marketing agencies, e-commerce brands, or local businesses as well. So I have been using Apollo from last 2 years and it has been working great for me. So I will be showing you how you can use Apollo to build lists in your niche and how you can use it to find more than 10,000 leads per month. So let's jump over to my screen and I'll show you how it works. This is how Apollo looks like. So basically we will be starting off by signing up to the platform. So you come to apollo.io and you will be redirected to this web page. And now we will sign up. So I already have an account, so I'll be just logging into my account, but you can just go ahead and sign up for free. So now I am inside Apollo. So this is the page you will be redirected to while you log in. So this is called Cockpit. So this will have all your updated daily activities. So like how many emails you sent yesterday or how many calls you did yesterday, how many were connected, how many emails were open. So I don't really use Apollo for sending emails, but I'll also show you how you can use it to send emails in another video, but this video is more focused on how you can use it to build more qualified prospect lists. So now let's go ahead and build a list. So you click on search and find the people's tab. So this is where you have to build out your list. So you can see there are like 249 million contacts. So now you have to filter down your criteria to what you are actually looking for. So basically I mostly work with software companies and, you know, service based companies. So in this video I will show you how you can use these filters to better target your prospects. So Apollo gives you these multiple filters to use so you can build out a more qualified leads and maybe use those filters as a personalization point as well. So now I will be building a list targeting B2B software companies in New York State, obviously, who are using HubSpot and have at least $1 million revenue. So this is a very targeted list and I'll use all this as a personalization point in my emails as well. So let's go ahead and see how it works. So first of all, I will be adding the location which I am looking my contacts in. So you can see there are almost 2 million contacts in New York. So that's a pretty large data set, right? So now let's go ahead and filter it based upon the industry we are targeting. So, you know, we will be targeting software businesses. So I will use computer software and information technology as my industry targets. And now I will further filter down this industry based on the keywords as well. So I only want to target B2B software companies, not any B2C software companies, right? So I'll add this filter as well. So B2B, they should be a B2B company. So there were like 94,000 contacts, you see, right, for these two industries. But now when I filter it based upon B2B companies, I get like 26,000. I will try to keep my data set lower than 1,000 leads. Right. Also, you can see there are four type of keywords you can use. Either the keyword can be in company name, social media tags, or social media description or SEO description. So I will be adding to everything. Okay, now we have almost 27,000 leads. Now let's filter them based upon the employee count as well. So the services that I am selling are only valid for companies who have less than 50 employees and maybe around more than 5 employees, because it's not really a fit if they have more than 50 employees, because they must be having an in-house team doing what we really do. So I will be targeting only 11 to 20 employees in this, 11 to 50 employees in this list. So you see now we have 3500 contacts in our dataset. So now let's filter it based on the technologies they use. So I want to target companies who are already using HubSpot. So you already know HubSpot is a marketing automation platform, right? So they are obviously investing in marketing. So we can definitely help them improve their results, right? So now we have 1300 total targets, but we still have two filters to use. So first is revenue. So if you remember, I told you we will be targeting companies who have at least $1 million revenue. So until this processes, so let me give you some insights. So whenever you are going ahead building a list on Apollo, make sure you are not just relying on industries you are targeting, you use keywords as well. Because sometimes Apollo doesn't have the right database on the industries, but it gives you great database on the keywords. So sometimes what happens is you want to target marketing agencies. But what I prefer is I prefer to go more niche based. So I will go ahead and target only TikTok based marketing agencies, right? So I will put TikTok and the keywords while I'm choosing marketing, you know, services as an industry. That will give me a much better results, right? So now we have 982 targets in our list, but this is not the final list as well. So, you know, we have not really filtered it based upon the roles we want to target. So the services we are selling is basically is to smaller companies, right? So in smaller companies, basically there are 3-4 roles who are basically responsible for making decisions, right? So I will be including all those roles when building out this list. So I'll go ahead and choose the job titles I want to target. So first is CEO, obviously. So I'll target owners as well. So in this step, you can basically go ahead and put all the roles you want to target, and Apollo will filter your list based on that, right? So you see now we have a very targeted list. So I'm going to be putting in a few more roles and I'll get back to you. So now I have really narrowed down my targeting list. So let me show you how you can go ahead and export this leads as well. So you see there are 3 tabs. First is the total number of leads in your all these filters. Second is the net new leads which you have not already saved. And third is the column which have all the leads you have already saved. So you see I have already saved 26 leads previously, but I have won 13 new leads. So what I'm going to do is I will go to the second column and I will start saving these leads. So let me show you how to do it. So you have to click on here and select this page. So in this $99 per month plan, Apollo lets you select only 25 leads at a time. So you have to manually save all these leads until, you know, you save all those leads, and then you will be able to export this through this column. So this is how Apollo works. You filter down the leads based on your criteria and it will show you the total number of leads in your data set. Then it will show you the net new leads which you have to save, and it will show you how many leads you have already saved which you can just export right now if you want. But now I will go ahead and save all these 130 leads as well. So I'll see you after saving the leads, right? So now I have saved all these 156 leads, and now I will go ahead and export these. So now you can select all these leads in one go. So you come here and select all 156 people and click export, and you click export all emails, because you don't export verified emails only, because we will be verifying these emails with another software. Then there you have it. So I'll just create a new Google Sheet to import this list, and so we can, you know, further filter down this list to make it usable, right? So I have created a new Google Sheet, so I will rename it. I'll just add all the filters I have used to build out this list. So when I come back to this list in future, I can know which filters I used when building out this list, right? So this is how Apollo will export your sheet. So I will remove the unnecessary data which we don't really need. So I always keep only these columns in my sheet. Now you see we exported 156 leads. So it has 156 leads, but it will not give you emails for everybody, because obviously Apollo doesn't have emails for everybody, but they still charge you for exporting this lead. So I don't know why they do it. So it has like 149 leads and 6 of these are blank. So first of all, I will remove this rows. So you can still use these leads for a LinkedIn campaign. So I will save them in a separate column. So what I'll do is I'll just run a LinkedIn only campaign on these leads. So I will rename the sheet as emails, because it will have leads that we will be only using for sending cold emails. And I'll rename this sheet as the LinkedIn, because we will send LinkedIn connection request to these leads. So now I have deleted these leads from here. So now you have 149 emails of prospects. So now what I will do is I'll download this sheet and I will validate all these emails through our email validation software, because I know for sure that all of these emails are not verified, but we will still can get like 60 to 70% of these emails. So let's go ahead and I'll come back with the results. So now I have verified this list through emaillistvalidation.com. So you can use any validation software, maybe it's Neverbounce, Debounce, whichever you are using, maybe it's Snow as well. So I have got around 80% of the leads is verified. So I'll show you how to get more leads from this list as well. So first of all, I will remove any leads who are the spam or email disabled, who have email disabled, right? I will not remove these leads. We can still use them for a LinkedIn campaign, obviously. So what happens is whenever you are using an email validation software, it will also give you a list of emails which are unknown to them as well. So they are maybe valid or maybe risky to send. So here is the method which you can use to get verified emails from that list. So I'll copy this list from here and I'll add it to another sheet. I'll paste it here. So you have to again copy this email column and paste it here. So now you go here and convert this to people chips and see, Google Sheets will tell you which of these emails is usable. Most of these emails are pretty usable. So what I'll do is first of all, delete these leads from here. Now you have only verified leads in the first sheet, right? You have like 122 emails with which are valid, right? Now you have this list of, you know, this is the list which had unverified emails. Now whichever email has that people chip, this is a sendable email. So I'll copy these leads from here and paste it into my email sending sheet. So also there is a quick way to do it, so I'll show you that as well. I don't know why I was doing it manually. So you go and you select the custom formula, you press not, and you first write the column, which is it's in the D column, right? And your email starts from second row. So you put into and you click equal to. So now you have to check in the column in which you put in the duplicate email address, which is the I column. So I'll do this. And now you click on OK and now you will have this. So now you can copy this and just paste it here. So now these are all the leads. Now you have 134 emails which are sendable. And you delete these. Now you will still have this 4 or 5 leads which are usable for a LinkedIn campaign. So this is how you build list using Apollo. So what you can do is just go ahead and start sending emails to these leads. But mostly before sending these emails, I always ask my team to personalize these emails because I don't really want to spam anybody. I want to use personalization as well. Maybe it's a little bit of strategic personalization which doesn't require a lot of research and time. But we still do it. So that's all for this video, guys. So that's how you use Apollo to build qualified prospect list. Let me know if you have any questions. And in next videos, I will show you how you can use Apollo to send emails and how you can enrich data using Apollo. So look out for those videos. See you in the next. Bye. Cheers.